This year, we celebrate the 100th anniversary of the 19th Amendment. The 19th Amendment, guaranteeing women the right to vote, became part of the United States Constitution in 1920. This victory was long fought and hard won by women volunteers who expertly organized themselves and advocated for change in their community.
Nannie Helen Burroughs was an educator, she was a writer, she was a speaker, she was an activist, and she was a suffragist. Nannie Helen Burroughs was one of the people that helped to found this Women's Convention Auxiliary of the National Baptist Convention. She used it as a place where she and other women could have their voices heard. We think of clubs as being an after-school activity, but in the early 20th century, they were very popular with adults. There were clubs devoted to activism, clubs devoted to suffrage. They were all there to serve a purpose. And part of that purpose was to bring people together to work for change. Clubs, organizations, grassroots movements, these are all tactics for reform we still use today. They're a place where we find our friends, we find our allies, and we find our mission, where you come together and change the world.
For 72 years, women marched and lobbied for change before the 19th Amendment was ratified. During this time, women had to convince the men in political power to vote in their favor. On August 26, 1920, the 19th Amendment was ratified and became a part of the United States Constitution. Today, more than 68 million women vote in elections in the United States because of the courageous efforts of women who organized themselves, received training, and volunteered their time to this worthy cause. On this centennial, we say thank you to the women who fought in and led this movement, including Susan B. Anthony, who played a pivotal role in securing the right to vote for women.
It used to be said that a sure sign of spring in Washington, D.C. was when this red shawl was seen in the halls of the Capitol, because its wearer was lobbying Congress. Lobbying can have a bad reputation. We think about big money, dark rooms, and secret meetings. But lobbying is also a way for individuals, for groups, to talk to their congresspeople. So who was wearing that shawl? It was Susan B. Anthony. She devoted her life to working for woman suffrage. The only way for women to get the vote was to convince the men who ran government to pass the laws that would make it happen. And to do that, you got to do a little lobbying. Susan spent decades talking to congressmen. She trained a new generation of suffrage leaders, passing the shawl, so to speak. And they continued the fight. 14 years after she died, the suffrage amendment was finally ratified. In her last public speech, Anthony declared, "Failure is impossible." She was right.
In the words of Susan B. Anthony, "This closes the records of the 19th century of work done by and for women. What the 20th century will show, no one can foresee. But that it will be vastly more and better, we cannot fail to believe. But you and I have done the best we knew, and so must rest content, leaving all to younger hands." We hope to carry on the legacy of our suffragette sisters, training and empowering women volunteers to make meaningful and lasting change to better the communities we serve.